It's time to hog the airwaves with bikers' first-hand adventures across the country. Ride with us and keep yourself informed on issues, events, and everything else bikers want to know. The road is their home, and it's time to find out where are they now. Listening to Good Time Charlie on Biker's Inner Circle Underground Radio.
Okay, I'm going to give you a little quick tour of where I live and what I do. And most of what you're going to see is from my wife, who is an artist and a quilter. And that was her Christmas quilt that was hanging this last year, Christmas. And I haven't got her to take it down yet. I told her, I said, doesn't the Christmas quilt come down now? And so she's going to do that real soon. Now, right behind you,
this is a commemorative quilt honoring the sesquicentennial anniversary of the beginning of the Civil War.
These are all
Civil War reproduction fabrics. Wow. And there are over 1,200 triangles in that quilt.
This is beautiful.
This quilt that you're looking at here is a reproduction commemorative sesquicentennial quilt for the beginning of the Civil War, and all of the material and fabrics in there are reproductions of Civil War fabrics.
Wow.
Did I do that good?
You did. I would have stuttered all through that one.
Okay, this is the playroom, the jukebox. Oh, I should turn that on and get some light on it so you can see it.
Oh, yeah, that's some old school stuff here.
We'll do that again.
And that's from an astronaut right up here?
That's Neil Armstrong.
That's Neil.
The guy who landed on the moon.
Yeah.
He was a friend of mine.
Wow.
And he didn't sign autographs.
Wow.
And I sent him a tape of a song that a friend of mine wrote called Armstrong. And I was down making a movie with Billy Bob Thornton in Houston. And they gave us a tour of the Space Center, Houston. Well, they gave us a bunch of photos, and I found that one. And I wrote him a letter, and I sent two of those photos. And he's a guy that I knew as Neil, but I always called him Mr. Armstrong. And I wrote him a note, and I said, Mr. Armstrong, I know you don't sign autographs, but would it be out of the question to ask you to sign one of these for me and one for my grandson? It would mean the world to both of us. He sent me this back with the two photographs signed and the letter. You got to read the letter, man. I'm going to read this letter to you. Oh, let me turn this on. The letter says, Dear Mickey, thanks for your note. I have watched your career with great interest over recent years, and I'm delighted to see that all is going well with you. I am delighted to return the print you sent with my best wishes. My golf game is a bit corroded, but I hope we have the opportunity to play together one of these days. We did play together a few times. This may be the year when it all comes together. All the best, sincerely, Neil A. Armstrong.
Wow.
Now, is that kind of cool?
Yeah, that's very cool.
So let me move
that. That's very cool. Chariots of the Gods. Cool.
I mean, that's the astronaut of astronauts.
Yeah, and this is a poster you guys from...
Oh, that's Kenny Rogers. The first. That came out of the album Something's Burning.
Wow.
And you see what I have on top of my pinball machine.
Oh, yeah. Indian.
It's an old Indian. And then you got to check this Indian out. That's a pretty cool Indian.
Oh, yeah.
That's a real perfect scale of an Indian. And I'm an Indian guy. And this is a picture that was in Easy Rider magazine, and my wife thought that was one of the best photographs of me, and so I framed it and gave it to her. And that's the airplane my dad learned to fly on.
Wow.
Steerman. Got the an old fireball pinball machine.
The old 5 cent classic. Slot?
Huh?
5 cents?
Yeah. Got a couple of 5 cent slot. Oh, they're both five. Yeah. No, this is a 10 cent.
Yeah.
Sorry. So, and there's my my picture that the Beatles signed to me.
Wow.
And then just below it is the picture of me and
with the Beatles. Beatles.
With the Beatles.
So you got a picture hanging with the Beatles.
Well, they were our opening act.
You're the fifth Beatle.
I hung out with them for about 6 or 8 weeks.
Unbelievable.
In Paris, at the Olympia Theater in Paris. And
when I grow up, I want to be just like you, Mickey.
Oh, check this out. This is kind of cool. I don't know how I'm, you might have to get over your shoes. Yeah. That knife was made personally, for me personally, by the Buck Knife Company. And
wow.
they made two of them. They made one for me, and they made one for me to auction off at my golf tournament. And I think I got a lot of dough for it. But I'm so honored to have... My personal buck knife. And if you look in the middle, that's a golfer.
Yeah, and speaking of golf.
Cut out.
You got a pretty cool song on the Tin Cup.
Oh, yeah, Double Bogey Blues.
It's on my radio show.
That's the real golf song.
Yeah.
And
that was with Kevin Costner, right?
Kevin Costner. Have this set up so we can play darts.
Cool.
Haven't done it in a while. And I have a little board down here, so when my wife throws a dart, it's a little low.
So, yeah, that's a pretty cool song.
This is what my wife and I do every night.
All right. Nine ball or eight ball?
We shoot eight ball. Yeah. She's not a big fan of nine ball, but I love nine ball.
I love nine ball, too.
And we had a couple over last night for dinner that the guy that I'm going to do the, it's like a concert where I'm going to talk about my book and show clips and sell books. Well, he and his wife came over to discuss that. They have a company called Hi-Hat Entertainment.
Uh-huh.
And I happened to mention, I said, my wife and I, we shoot pool almost every night. And my wife's getting pretty good. And I said, I don't know if you guys want to shoot a game of pool. And they were real reluctant. They didn't say anything. And I said, so what do you guys do at home? And he said, well, my wife is a professional pool player, and I play with professionals, and I make custom cues. I said, are you kidding me? You're kidding me. We got up and played pool. I took his wife for a partner. My wife got him, and I'm telling you, they're as professional as any professional I've ever seen in my life. I never saw anybody shoot pool like that, and I'm not terrible. And they made shots that I went, forget it. Because he said, well, you know, if you want to put that hard left-hand English, hit that ball straight in and have the ball hit there because you want the cue ball back up here, you have to know how to do that. Well, I just, wherever it goes. I try to put it in position, but...
Yeah, they know all the English and all that stuff.
Professional pool.
Yeah.
So anyway, so check this out.
Wow.
My wife made that facial quilt, and that's me.
Yeah, you can definitely tell.
Is that a trip? And then the quilt underneath it, she made for me. It's called A Few of His Favorite Things.
Yeah, golf,
and
motorcycles Corvettes,
and golf, and Corvettes,
Route 66.
And sharks, and Dallas Cowboys, and airplanes. And my wife is so.
Well, bad. I guess you don't really want to talk about Tony Romo then, do you?
Tony Romo, I'm cowboy crazy. I didn't know there were other teams for the longest time. But after this last game, they should have escorted Tony Romo to the locker room and said, pack your things and go home.
We need Roger Staubach back.
Yeah, or Craig Morton.
Yeah.
Troy wasn't
Troy.
Bad either.
Oh, Troy was.
But, you know.
I don't think he's going to have too
I
much.
Wanted to support Tony.
Yeah.
But he just, you know what? He can't deliver.
No.
When it counts, he can't deliver. And there really ought to be a new quarterback next year.
I think they're going to be looking for one. Because Jerry Jones don't like
I hope so.
Waiting.
Okay, you got to see this. You may have to go back up way over here.
Okay.
This is, there's only 13 here, but I have 17.
Wow.
The others are out in the garage that just didn't have a place for them. And, but I'm honored to have made all the gold records that I have. And, here, this is cool. You asked me this question a while ago. This, I won the Frank Sinatra Celebrity Golf Tournament.
Wow. So you're pretty good in golf, huh?
I was. I used to be fair.
It was easy for you to come up with that song,
this
huh?
This is, a friend of mine wrote it, but we co-publish it.
Oh, okay.
This is Gene Krupa with Gene Krupa's signature.
Man, I love Gene.
A friend of mine sent me this.
Wow. You ever got to play with him?
I never played with him, but I saw him in person. When I was about 19 or 20, I was in New York City, and he was playing at the Metropole. And the bouncer, I couldn't go in, but the bouncer, he played up over the bar. But the bouncer had me stand right next to the door, even though I couldn't go in, so I could watch him play. And I watched him play two sets.
Wow.
And it was pretty cool.
So this is really an honor to see this, Mickey.
Well, you got the 50 Cent tour.
I got the double platinum tour. And this is you right here, huh?
That's me.
Boy, you was mean looking there.
Well,
boy.
I was playing a wrestler. Or as I say in Texas, a wrestler.
That's
and you know what's funny? I go places. I'll just tell you the name of my new book. The last book I wrote was called That Would Be Me. And it was that was my line on Home Improvement. When he'd say, P. Bilker, can be construction. And I'd look in the lens and I'd go, that would be me. Now, everywhere I go, because of having done 88 feature films, 500 TV shows, 500 commercials, people come up to me in airports everywhere. They go, hey, I know you. You're that guy. Well, don't tell me, because I know who you are. You're that guy that... You're on, and the name of my new book is I Am That Guy.
Yeah.
Which is a perfect title.
Yes, it is.
So.
Yeah.
Well, hope you've had a little bit of fun today.
Oh, I did. I wonder if there's any way we could sneak a look at the main thing that why I love you the most. Your motorcycle.
Oh, yeah, come on. Just don't look too hard at the garage.
Oh, hey. You should see my garage.
I'll open the door. You don't have to come out here.
And folks, this is one of the main reasons why we came to do this interview.
Yeah.
Because Mickey is really a motorcycle guy. Look at this beautiful bike.
That's the real deal.
What year is this one?
It's the 2001, which is the centennial year of Indian. It's a bad ride, too, and it runs like a
top. Oh, yeah. Well, I rode with you in the Lacey ride. It's the same one, right?
Or is it different? I love that S&S engine. That all-American S&S motor, man, means the world to me.
Yeah, it's a beautiful bike, man.
I love it. I haven't had it out. I got it out for Love Ride, and then it was raining.
All right, Mickey. Hey.
Pleasure, man.
Thank you, Mickey.
He just hugs me and kisses me.
I love this man.
I don't know. Where's this guy coming from?
Motorcyclism. You've seen it here.
The real motorcyclism.
Yes, it is.
All right.
I love you, man.
All right, I'm going to show you that clip from Justified.
All right.